Hello everyone, this is Donjit Dhaka and you are watching me on my YouTube channel Chemistry Tutorial. So guys, in the last video we have discussed about the Schrodinger equation of hydrogen atom. In that video we have discussed about how we can separate the Schrodinger equation under three parts. Okay, first one is radial, polar and the azimuthal part. These are the three parts we have discussed. Okay, now in this video we are going to discuss about the solution of the first part, that is radial part of Schrodinger equation. So let us see what is the radial equation was. So it was the d delta of r square delta eight pi square mr square divided by h square e plus v r into beta into r. Okay, this is the radial equation we have found in the last class. You need not to remember this. Okay, you just need to remember the solution of this equation. Now we'll see what is the solution of this differential equation. This is a second order differential equation, and solution of this equation will be the r. Okay, before writing the solution, let us consider a function x equal to, suppose you consider x equal to twice of g r or z r divided by n into n naught. I will tell you what is n here, small n here, and n naught here. Okay, then since it is x is a, since x is a function of r, we can write the r, the wave function r, capital R, as a function of x. Okay, so it will be a normalization constant. This is the solution of the radial equation. Okay, normalization constant x to the power l, capital L, twice L plus 1 n plus L into the function of x and e to the power minus x by 2. This is the solution of the above equation. Okay, here n it is normalization constant. Normalization constant, we'll see the value, what is normalization constant. And this term L twice L small l plus 1 to n plus L and x. Okay, this part is called associated Lagor polynomial. I'm not sure about the spelling. Okay, this is called Lagor polynomial. Polynomial. And here n, it ranges from 1, 2, 3, like that. Okay, this is called principal quantum number. Whereas L, it is angular quantum number. It will ranges, it is an integer, ranges from 0, 1 to n minus 1. Okay, so this is the radial equation where we consider x equal to twice of z r divided by n into a naught, where n it is the principal quantum number and L it is the angular quantum number. And this a naught, it is the Bohr radius. Remember this, this is called Bohr radius. Okay, now we'll see what is the value of this normalization constant and associated polynomial. Okay, so this is the solution of the radial equation. So the normalization constant n here, it is given by root over x by r to the power 3 n minus l minus 1 factorial divided by twice of n, n plus l factorial to the power 3. Okay, this is the value of normalization constant, where n it is principal quantum number, its values will be from 1, 2, 3 like that. Okay, and l it is the angular quantum number and its value will be from 0, 1, 2 up to n minus 1. Okay, now we'll see what is Legor polynomial, associated Legor polynomial. This associated Legor polynomial is a function of x. Okay, suppose you consider this twice l plus 1, it is as k p and it is equal to k. So it will be the value of ddx differential with respect to x or p, pth differential, okay, into e to the power x, okay, ddx. Now you take derivative, kth derivative, okay, n minus l, n plus l or k, kth derivative, e to the power, sorry, x to the power k into e to the power minus of l. So this is the expression for associated Legor polynomial. I'll show you how to calculate this Legor polynomial easily. Now we'll discuss about derivation of Legor polynomial. I am not sure of this spelling, okay? You just verify this. To derive the Legor polynomial, first you consider a simple function y equal to x to the power k e to the power minus x. Okay, you first consider this function y equal to x to the power k e to the power minus x. Now you derive this function with respect to x. Okay, so k8 up to k8. Okay. So k derivative of this function would be ddx of y would be ddx up to k term x to the power k e to the power minus of x. Okay, now you can write this as a e to the power minus of x e to the power x dx up to k term x to the power k e minus x. Okay, you can write like this. Okay, this will cancel out and give you the same term. Okay, now this term, it is represented by lx and it is called Legor polynomial. Now you derive this Legor polynomial Lx up to pth term. So pth derivative of Lkx, pth derivative of y. Okay. So this is called L K P into X. So it would be D D X. This is up to pth term, okay? E to the power X D D X to kth term, X to the power K, E to the power minus X. So it is very easy, okay?
Very easy to find out. This is how you have to find out the Legor polynomial. First, you have to consider a simple function, that is y equal to x to the power k into e to the power minus x. Now we'll see some example how to find out the wave function of radial part of Schrodinger equation by taking different values of principal quantum number n and angular quantum number small l. So till now, what we have discussed? We have discussed about the radial equation of hydrogen atom, and we have discussed about the solution of that radial equation, that is radial wave function. So what is the radial wave function? This is the radial wave function. It depends upon x. It is given by a normalization constant into x to the power l, and the associated Legor polynomial twice l plus 1, and n plus l, it will be the function of x e to the power minus of x by 2. So this is the radial solution or radial wave function, okay? So this radial wave function depend upon two factor, two term, that is n and small l. This n represent here the principal quantum number which values will be 1, 2, 3 like that, okay? And the L value will be 0, 1, 2 like that up to n minus 1. So now we'll see what for different values of n and L, we'll see the wave function, that is radial wave function. What will be the radial wave function? So first you consider n equal to 1 and L equal to 0. When n equal to 1, L will be 0. In this case, you see the radial wave function be rx would be n into x to the power 0 l twice l plus 1, it would be 1, and n plus l, it would be 1 into x e to the power minus x by 2, where x is equal to twice of j dr divided by n into n naught. Okay, this function we have considered. Now we'll find out the normalization constant and this associated polynomial. First we'll see the normalization constant. What is the normalization constant here? So normalization constant, it is given by n minus of root over x by r cube n minus l minus 1 factorial, okay, twice of n l plus l, this will be also factorial, 2 to the power 3 root over whole, okay. So you place x here, x is twice z r, okay. So x by r would be twice of j divided by n, here it is 1, so n naught to the power 3. So n minus l, 1 minus 0 factorial of this one, twice of n would be 2 into 1, 1 plus 0 factorial to the power 3 whole root over, okay. This will come out as twice of, there will be a minus, okay. So twice of z a naught 3 by 2 if we remove the root over, okay, this term. So in this case we can write 1 divided by 2, 1 divided by 2 root over. There is a minus here, okay.
and this will result you as z twice of z a naught 2 to the power 3 by 2 into 2. There not be 2. Okay. So this is the normalization constant. Now we have to find out the this associated Lagard polynomial. So we write down this normalization constant here, the side. What we have found, n equal to minus of z a naught 3 by 2 into 2. Now we will find out what the Lagard polynomial. So write down the Lagard polynomial here. Okay, so L1x, it would be what? Ddx up to 1 star e to the power x ddx of 2 to the power k here it is 1. Okay, it would be 1. So x to the power k 1 e to the power minus of x. So we can easily find out this, since you see it can be find out by a tricks I'm showing you. You see here it is x to the power 1. Okay, so first you write, since it is an odd number, first you write minus x to the power 1, then you write plus, then you derive this x ddx to the power 1. Okay, then you multiply 1. So this would be the result. So this would give you minus x plus 1. Okay, so in place of here we can write 1 minus x. So ddx 1 minus x. So this would give you minus of 1. So what we have found, the associated polynomial value, it is minus 1. L1x, it is minus of 1. Now we'll put this value, the normalization constant value and the associated Lagard polynomial on this function, radial function. So you see, this is n, okay? So n would be minus 2 z by a naught 3 by 2. X to the power 0, it is 1. L, it is minus of 1. And e to the power minus of x by 2. So minus minus plus 2 into z a naught 3 by 2 e to the power minus x by 2. So this is the radial wave function. It is a function of x here. So now we'll convert this radial wave function into a function of r. So to convert this function to a function of r, we just put x equal to twice of z r divided by a naught. So it would be 3 by 2 e to the power z r by a naught. So this is the radial wave function for n equal to what? For n equal to 1 and n equal to 0. Now we'll see another example where n equal to 2 and l equal to 0. So let us see.
So in this case, the radial wave function would be n into x to the power l, here it is 0, l twice of 0 plus 1, n plus l 2 plus 0 x e to the power minus of x by 2. So now we will calculate the normalization constant and the Lagar polynomial. First we will see the normalization constant. So let us see what is normalization constant. It would be root over x by r to the power 3 n minus l minus 1 factorial twice of n l n plus l factorial to the power 3 whole root over. Now we'll put the value z x here. You see x would be twice of zr divided by 2 n naught. So here we can write z by a naught to the power 3 by 2. There will be a minus here, and in place of n we can write 2 minus 1 root over factorial 2 into 2 2 plus 1 factorial to the power 3 whole root over. So minus of z a naught 3 by 2, in the numerator it would be 1 and the denominator 4 into 8. This can be write as three by 2, 1 by 4 root 2. So this is the value of normalization constant. So I'll write here on the side. N equal to minus of z a naught 3 by 2, 1 by 4 root 2. Now we'll find out the associated Lagar polynomial. So what we have find out? We have find out the normalization constant. Now we are going to find out this Lagar polynomial. So let us see what is the Lagar polynomial here. What will be the value? So it is L 1 2 x. So it would be d dx of up to p term. Here p is equal to 1. So 1 e to the power x d dx up to k term. Okay. So here k it is 2 up to 2. So x to the power k, that is 2 e to the power minus of x. So we can find out this value by a simple trick. You see here it is x square. So you just first write x square plus x square. Okay. In this case, first you put plus positive sign, then you derive this with respect to x, then minus twice of x into 2. Again you derive this term plus twice of, it would be 4. Okay, this is how you have to find out. So it would be d dx of this much. So again if you derive this one, we will get what? Twice of x minus of 4. So this is the Lagar polynomial value. So what we have found? N is equal to minus of z by a naught, okay, 2 to the power 3 by 2, n
1 by 4 root 2 and x to the power 0 it would be 1 and Lagrange polynomial here it is twice x minus 4 that is x minus 2 2 into x minus 2 2 we have take common here and e to the power minus of x by 2 so it would be minus of z by a naught 3 by 2, 2 to cancel out two root 2 x minus 2 e to the power minus of x by 2 so this is the radial wave function in terms of x okay when n equal to 2 and l equal to 0 so now we'll convert this into a function of small r so we'll put in place of x we'll put what x equal to twice of zr divided by twice of a naught three by two one by two root two x zr divided by a naught minus 2 e to the power zr divided by a naught twice a naught so this would be the radial wave function so this would be the radial wave function for n equal to 2 and l equal to 0 okay This is how we can calculate radial wave function for different values of n, l, l. Okay. So, this is it for today's video. In the next video, we will discuss about the solution of the other parts. That is angular part and the azimuthal part. Then after that, we will just cover all the discussion in a short video. In one shot, we will discuss all the wave function. The spherical harmonics will be discussed in that video. In the third video from this today. So I hope guys you have understand all the things I have discussed here. If you have any doubt, you can ask me by dropping your comment on the comment section below. And if you are new to the channel, then don't forget to subscribe our channel and press the bell icon also so that you can get the notification of this video as soon as I uploaded a video on this channel. So you can follow us on Facebook. The link of Facebook group and the Facebook page is given in the description box. You just go there and follow us. So this is it for today's video. We'll see you in the next video. Till then, thank you guys.